Can you think of any other time since the Civil War where anybody said things like that, where it's happened, where violence is condoned? Look what happened. My friend Paul, I shouldn't even get in, I'll get going. But Nancy Pelosi's husband, look what the Republican said. Some of them making fun of it or making excuses. There's never been a time in my career when we've glorified violence based on a political basis. Let me close with this. Today, as I said earlier, we face one of those inflection points, one of those moments that not only comes around every three, four, five generations. We all know it in our bones that our democracy is at risk. Latest polls say 76% of American people worry about maintaining our democracy. And we know that this is your generation's moment to defend it, to preserve it, to choose it.
This election isn't a referendum, it's a choice. It's a choice between two fundamental...
You know, there are more than 300 Republican candidates for state, local, and federal office who are election deniers, who say that I did not win the election, even though the hundreds of attempts to challenge that have all failed, even in Republican courts. Well, Kathy's opponent is one of those election deniers. These deniers not only are trying to deny your right to vote, they're trying to deny your right to have your vote counted. No, I'm not joking. I'm not joking. With these election deniers, there are only two outcomes for any election. Either they win or they were cheated. No, I'm serious. Think about it. But let me tell you something. You can't only love the country when you win.
Your job, an unemployment rate, 6.4%. You lost manufacturing.
There's more. Republicans in Congress, led by South Carolina Senator Lindsey Graham, already introduced legislation for a national ban on the right to choose. Now, Governor Hochul is the first woman to serve as governor of New York. And on Tuesday night, with your help, she'll be the first woman elected governor of New York. And even before the Dobbs decision came down, your governor took action to protect patients and doctors to ensure that the right to choose for a woman in New York would be protected. And her opponent, meanwhile, believes that there should be no exceptions, even for rape or incest, none. His position is extreme.
More to do with what this country looks like 20 years from now than anything else. You know, let's...